next highest occupied molecular orbitals of scandium PP4 and titanium PP4 compounds have compositions similar to their MP counterparts. And highest occupied molecular orbitals of iron PP4, nickel PP4, copper PP4, and zinc PP4 compounds have significant contributions from metal and phosphorus atoms. However, the MP tetrapyrrole counterparts have zero contributions of the metal and nitrogen atoms in the same HOMO orbital. Also, there are noticeable composition differences for the highest occupied molecular orbitals of the cationic MPP4 species compared to their MP counterparts. MPP4 species have significant contributions of the phosphorus atoms compared with zero contributions of the nitrogen atoms in the metal tetrapyrrole species. Okay, and now conclusions and perspective for this piece of research. First, as was mentioned before, complete substitution of the pyrrole nitrogens by phosphorus atoms does not change the calculated ground spin state and ordering of spin states of compounds. Next, all MPP4 compounds studied possess a pronounced bowl-like shape. The cationic species have structures very similar to their neutral counterparts. Third, the positive NBO charges on the metals in MPP4 are generally lower than charges on the metals in the tetrapyrrole counterparts, and there is significant positive charge accumulation on phosphorus atoms. Both calculated HOMO-LUMO gaps and optical gaps for the MPP4 species are noticeably smaller than for the MP counterparts. And from this, the following questions can be set up. How would counter ions affect structures and properties of the cationic MPP4 species? How will annulation with different rings affect MPP4 species? And how strongly can MPP4 species interact with each other or with other molecules, with small molecules like nitrogen, hydrogen, oxygen, or with nanoparticles and so on? Okay, and this paper results of this research were presented at the virtual conference of computational chemistry in University of Mauritius in August last year, and my presentation was selected as one of the three best electronic presentations. Okay, yeah, and now I would like to attract your attention to the follow-up study, which is devoted to comparative investigation of the metal ligand binding energies in tetrapyrrole compounds and in compounds with four phosphorus atoms for all transition metals of the first row in the periodic table. So this scheme summarizes general results obtained. Summarizes some results obtained so far, that HOMO-LUMO gaps for all MPP4 compounds were smaller than for the tetrapyrrole original compounds, and binding energies between ligand and metal cation in tetrapyrrole compounds were in generally higher than in MPP4 compounds. But same ground states were calculated, and similar changes of binding energies were observed. And this I will show you right now. This scheme shows relative stabilities of spin states for MPP4 compounds. And this scheme shows relative stabilities of calculated spin states for metal tetrapyrrole compounds. So as was mentioned before, ground spin states were calculated to be the same for both MPP4 and metal tetrapyrrole compounds. And this scheme shows changes in binding energies between M2+ cation and ligand for MPP4 compounds and also for their tetrapyrrole counterparts. as I mentioned before, for tetrapyrrole counterparts, binding energies are noticeably higher than for MPP4 compounds. So this research is currently ongoing. So what has been done here, that different spin states for all compounds of interest are checked currently using using three more hybrid density functionals and two generalized gradient approximation density functionals. Also, cationic compounds are included for the for the fullness of the picture, and binding energy values are supposed to be calculated with different functionals as well. And of course, not only homoluma gaps, but optical gaps are supposed to be studied for all the species, for all the compounds under investigation. Now, I would like to mention more follow-up work, several more ongoing projects, sub-projects within this project. First is devoted to computational study on how modification of the ligand from tetraphosphor porphyrin to tetraphosphor phthalocyanin could affect structural and electronic properties of and also metal ligand binding energies for MPP4 derivatives for the metals of the first transition row. Second subproject is devoted to computational study of effects of counter ions and modification of the ligand from tetraphosphor porphyrin to tetraphosphor porphyrin with four benzene rings attached and on structural and electronic properties of the and also metal ligand binding energies on derivatives of metal tetraphosphor porphyrins. Third subproject is devoted to investigation of dimers or stacks of tetraphosphor porphyrin compounds. So far, I have found that the molecules of metal tetraphosphor porphyrins, when placed against each other, tend to attain this kind of conformation or configuration, and they keep their pronounced structural feature, as we can see. But what is significant here, that binding energies calculated with bisrelip approach were shown to be relatively low here, about several kilocalories per mole. It means that that different calculation approaches and also different media, different solvents should be checked here to make sure that these are not any artifacts, but the real structures. And also, it's necessary to understand why exactly these molecules like this kind of mutual orientation. One more subproject within this project is devoted to computational studies of complexes between fullerene C60 and MPP4 compound by analogy with complexes between C60 or C70 and metal porphyrins. Here I performed so far studies for zinc and nickel tetraphosphor porphyrin, and again different computational approaches should be checked here. And the fifth subproject within this project is investigation of activation of O2 and N2 by MPP4 species. Okay. Now let me show you some results obtained for the second project devoted to novel sandwich compounds. First, just a few words why these sandwich compounds are interesting for us. Here are examples of some well-known sandwich compounds made by made by transition metals and organic molecules, metallocenes. So, and what is especially interesting within this project is as follows: design of one-dimensional complexes or wires with more than one metal atom between two aromatic or non-aromatic ligands. Second, design of complexes with metal clusters, which these complexes would contain both organic and inorganic ligands. And of course, the most important is to answer the question, what new properties these sandwich complexes with metal clusters could have, and also to study possibilities to design two-dimensional and three-dimensional complexes with metal clusters, and of course, to answer the question, what their potential applications could be. Multiple metal centers in a single molecular unit lead to so-called cooperative effects, which could lead to potential applications in molecular electronics, catalysis, magnetic and optical materials, polymers, medicine, nanodevices, and so on. And potentially usual properties of such compounds could be facile redox behavior, easy derivatization, and also electron conductivity. And of course, these properties, they are closely related with potential applications. So research task in this project is theoretical design of sandwich complexes containing transition metal clusters and various organic and inorganic ligands. And here the following questions are supposed to be answered. What would be the largest number of transition metal atoms within a sandwich cluster at which the cluster the compound is still stable? Is it possible to make complexes with different transition metal clusters? And also, is it possible to make complexes containing several layers of transition metal clusters and ligands? And what could be maximum number of metal cluster layers and ligand layers at which the whole complex is still stable?